Tov.
Boker Tov. It's 4 in the morning. We're here leaving
Boker
Omaha.
Boker Tov.
So, Robert, Yevgeny looked really good yesterday.
Had a good fight. You know, durable kid that he was in front with.
It was nice.
What did you think about the draw? That was very surprising.
The rabbi of boxing.
Definitely was.
The rabbi of boxing?
Yes, he's the rabbi
it's
of boxing.
Part of the sport. You know what happens? Not the first time and not the last. It will not be the last. You know that. The judges, you know, make wrong decisions. You know, one of them had it right. Then the other two were kind of somewhere else. But what can we do? It's just how boxing is.
What does it say when Jason Velez himself and his trainer Abel come up to you guys and say, hey, we're not the judges. We know we didn't win.
Yeah, it's, you know,
is it respectful?
I mean, that's respectful. Those guys, they show that they understand the way boxing is, and they're going to, you know, they can't decide for the judges. Judges call the fights, and we have to go with whatever their decision is.
But it's good when you have true sportsmen like that to come and neutralize the situation and tell you how they feel, knowing that they truly lost, but and they wish they can have it, you know, differently, to be fair to everybody.
But you're proud of Yevgeny. He did what he had to do.
He's one of the hardest working guys in the gym. He's dedicated. He said in the dressing room, man, you know, I do everything right for 9 weeks, every day, morning, day, night, everything right. He says, my wife, my family, a little bit upset because I'm always very strict, you know, with my training and everything. He says, then I might not be doing enough.
How's it going?
I must not be doing enough, so I gotta do more. That's what he's thinking, you know. I might not be doing enough. I gotta do more. You know,
he did enough.
Yeah,
I mean, he looked
good.
Did you like the atmosphere in the gym?
It was nice.
Electric.
It was nice. You know, the Jewish crowd brings a lot of excitement into boxing here in Omaha. You know, a town where they haven't had much boxing, and now somebody like him comes out, big star. Everybody in HBO's talking about this guy, you know, that's huge. And you know, it's glad that it's coming to cities that have never had boxing before, you know, or at least in a long while. So
hey, good. Robert, I think the driver abandoned us. He ran back in because of the cold and he left us in here in the but this is what I noticed, and I told this to Crawford himself. He had over 12,000 fans there. Yes. They weren't boxing fans. They were Terrence Crawford fans.
Exactly. Wow. Terrence Crawford fans.
That's huge.
It is huge.
Yeah, but to pack an arena.
Impressive.
A place where I really didn't think the venue is going to draw that many people. What, 13,000 people today? It was absolutely impressive to have such a dedication to the sport, to the fans that really love the local guy, to come back and put together such a good venue. It's amazing.
I saw Mikey congratulated Crawford after when he tweeted. He said, hey, congratulations.
Oh, yeah. I didn't see any tweets, but yeah, that's good.
But a lot of people online, you know, they were saying good things.
No, that's good skills, good fighters. I think he needs a little more of that action, you know, risk thing in boxing, but he's not one of them. He's one that fights smart and gets the fights one little by little. He doesn't matter if he looks exciting or not. You know, he makes sure he wins the fights.
Absolutely.
And he does it in a pretty easy way. So
his face clean after the
exactly
fight.
So why not respect that? You gotta respect
that. Two stops at the airport. The first stop will be for American Airlines and Delta. The second stop will be for Southwest, United, and U.S. Airways.
Southwest.
Bye.